to Spain now, where Seth Doane takes us to an unusual oasis in the desert.
It's pretty much always tomato season here. Biosabor Farms ships to 24 countries and resembles an internet retailer at Christmas, but it's this busy all year round. Francisco Belmonte runs this organic farm in southern Spain, in one of the driest parts of Europe. We met amid acres of lush cucumber plants in one of his sprawling, high-tech greenhouses.
This is far from farming in your backyard.
In Almería, this garden in the middle of the desert, he said, it's the only way to produce. Almería appears shrink-wrapped. A plastic canopy stretches over more than 80,000 acres. It's criticized as a sea of plastic, he says, but under it is an Amazon jungle. And this plastic allows us to feed all of Europe during the winter. It's a miracle. In the movies, Almería's dry landscape was a stand-in for the dusty American frontier in dozens of westerns. But when they were shooting the desert train attack scene here for Lawrence of Arabia in the 1960s, another sort of production started. Building greenhouses, key to today's economy. This sea of plastic is now visible from outer space.
Yes, it's impressive, no?
Some would say it's a blight on the landscape. You say it's impressive.
It's impressive because they permit our production.
José Antonio Aliaga, the region's Secretary General of Agriculture, acknowledges issues in this production. They've cracked down on hiring undocumented workers, but migrants at one camp told us it's still possible to find a job without proper papers. And there are other costs. 98% of this plastic is recycled. It has to be replaced every 4 to 5 years.
These are huge greenhouses.
Yes, but it's a little percentage of our land. It's only the 3.5% of the province of Almería.
Whereas agriculture is 50% of the region's economy.
What would this place be without greenhouses?
Nothing, I think so.
At Gava Group, Vince Martins Conrado says challenges have sparked innovation. They train peppers to climb nearly 10 feet high to use less land. Drip irrigation maximizes water use.
Where does this water come from?
From the ocean.
Salt water is desalinated. They mix in fertilizer, but eliminated pesticides.
This attracts the insects you want.
That's right, that's right. The good insects to eat the bad insects.
AgroBio is a company working with growers to introduce plants that attract natural predators of pests. When that's not enough, Enrique Villa explained, they breed them.
These guys will eat pests on peppers.
Yeah.
These tiny bugs have been part of a major transformation. Farms in Almería had been using so many pesticides they were losing effectiveness. So since 2006, more than 70% of growers here have transitioned to using natural predators as pest control.
In a way, it's what we are doing is recovering the natural balance that was before our agriculture was established.
They're raising other insects as pollinators.
What the grower is getting is a colony like this, with one queen and around 80 workers.
These colonies are shipped worldwide. In Almería, they primarily pollinate tomatoes, which fill more than 16,000 football fields of greenhouses. This patch of desert has become Europe's orchard.